Gloria T. Brown, and Jane Adams. Pharmacist Albert Simmons, deceased. I should have said deceased on some of these other names, but we'll just keep going. Scientific research, Gerard Henderson, who works for the Navy. Attorneys, Howard Scott. Howard Scott was also a captain in the United States Army. Charles Anderson and Donna Henderson. Finance and business, Otis Hamilton, CPA, and we know our school board member, locksmith, Kenny Dennis. In religion, Bishop Billy Bass Jr., Bishop Jerry White, Bishop Tommy Hughes, Lord, and our presiding elder, Church of Dennis. School administrators, Charles Blaylock. I think he was a three-term or three-county superintendent. He started in Hamilton County, Swain County, and I think he went back to Hamilton, serving as superintendent. And then Lawrence Hughes served here in the local district in charge of instruction at the secondary level. School principal Richard Bell, the school principal over in Pensacola, one of the largest schools in Pensacola, was an editor of Eaton, and also Sidney Patterson was a principal down in the Tampa area. Athletics, Eugene McCray was an NFL player. I think he played for the Pittsburgh Steelers. And also he was a CPA out of the Texas area. And Joe Lewis White. Joe Lewis White was a prize fighter. Jeff Steele lives over by the track here. Joe was a prize fighter. Those some of the achievements at Jerkins High School. Rich history. The third area, leadership in the black community, the game changers. Leaders in the black community were men and women who could get things done and had the respect of the community at large. There were many black-owned businesses in the 50s and 60s from Drew Street, Washington, where they had Sheila's Canes in that area from there. There was black business there. Willow Street, that was probably the main business area. Restaurants and theater and drugstore, student centers and the other group we used to call them is JUKEs, I think, but all of those were there in that area. There were dry cleaners, there were a drugstore, and barbershops, several barbershops, and beauty salons. The Voters League had political influence. The Voters League was a strong group of men in the 50s and late 60s, such as Deacon Charlie Blaylock, Stuart Richard Bell Sr., and Mr. George Evans Sr. and Jr., and Deacon Tom Jones, just to name a few, who were concerned about the community voting. And they were involved in other kinds of issues, but Voters League is no longer operational now. The NAACP was organized around 1960 under the leadership of Reverend J.C. Bentley, who was the pastor of the New Brooklyn Church. And Deacon Smith Belcher was the longest serving president of the NAACP. Mrs. Stella Newberry, preschool pioneer in Taylor County, included Head Start director for many years at the Jerkins site. Vote 13, a women's organization that provided daycare services for years in the black community. A Christian woman's organization, a women's organization called TACO, Taylor Interdenomination of Christian Outreach, co-founded by Elder Carolyn Gibbs and Sister Lorraine Montgomery, was dedicated to developing young ladies in our community. Wings Over Joy. was a community choir that provided music for Taylor County and surrounding counties for years. And then the men's club dedicated to improve, which is built on the back end of Water Avenue, was built to improve the social activities in the community and to provide a building where social game changer in our community took place in 1979, when a group of concerned citizens organized as the Taylor County Leadership Council at Stewart Memorial Church. In 1980, the Leadership Council filed a class action suit on behalf of the black citizens of Taylor County against the city and county. Tommy Williams and the late Amos Delaware were the leaders in this suit. Results: street lights, paved roads, sewage connections in the black community, and the city park with a recreation building. Again, in 1984, another class action suit was filed against the city, county, and school board by the same group with the same leadership. And they were addressing at-large voting, seeking single-member voting districts. Results: single-member voting districts, with precinct 13 as one of the largest voting districts. Candidates must live in a district represented. White representation on the city councils, board of county commissioner, and the school board. Black female mayor, Shirley Curry. First black mayor, Thomas Gibbs. Number four.
Is there a problem?
My time is here, okay. My number one achievement. A lady that has influenced my life as long as I can remember in the community, church, and school. My number one achievement is a complete lineup. I'm a force in our community. Her name is Laura Scott Reeves, and she's about 96 years young. After our discussion last week, I left her home more captivated by her determination than ever before. She didn't finish high school at Jerkins, although she grew up. This is her home. She grew up in this community. She worked as a teacher in Dixie County around 1937, 1938, and 1939. After qualifying by exam, which she was encouraged to take the exam by her friend named Peggy Rocher, so that she could teach third grade in Dixie County. That was great. But she had to continue her education to continue teaching the next year. She couldn't attend Fountain City Florida College because she didn't have a degree. There was nowhere to go but to the University of Florida. who had an extension program. She took an extension program. But that was a problem, so she thought. She said people that looked like me could not attend university. But she confided in her grandmother, Miss Taylor, in tears. She was in tears. And her grandmother told her to go to the university in Gainesville. Don't go on that campus without telling me. So Miss Reed did just what her grandmother told her to do. By the way, the reason her grandmother wanted to know, because she was praying. As was really within her accounts. Okay, the results. And I have this, I said, if you did it, I got to have documentation. And I have documentation of that. But I have here her certificate from the University of Florida, indicating that Laura S. Reeves and they had C-O-L and Reeves is there. Has satisfied the requirements to extend her certificate dated 1943. And she probably went from third grade to fourth grade, she did fourth grade. And I said, wow, I've known all my life. I've never heard that story before. So great, great. Now, from there she received her AA degree from Florida Norman Industrial College, San Augustine in 1944. Now remind you what they usually were talking about. When I walked out the house, yeah, I said, hey, where did she get that? Her bus and so on and so on. In 1947 to 1950, she entered FAMU C, and earned a BA in elementary education. She taught school in Freetown, State of Dixon, Taylor, and Lafayette for more than 42 years. And in the meantime, my daughter was my age, so she was having a family while she was growing all of this. So now look at what she overcame to become an educator. I said, wow. She didn't stop there. She went back to school in 1992, received a degree in ministry services from Tumblr College in Virginia, Tennessee. She has a recent certificate from the Taylor County Institution in prison ministry slash volunteers. And just last year, she made an in-depth interview outlining the history of Taylor County for a doctoral memory of the University of Florida. And she says, I'm still learning at the dining room table. Daily. I said, Ms. Reed, I need that documentary.
Yes, yeah. Say the same thing.
Her granddaughter has it, and I think we're going to work to get help with that. So when I think, I said, wow, the inspiration that, and the love and the drive that she still has for learning and for people at 96 years of age. Is inspirational. Last, thank you again for the opportunity to share with you about a place I call home. I am the product of the roots of Springfield, and I'm blessed. I completed high school with Jerkins in 1967, married to Lorraine Montgomery, Lorraine Hutton, March 1971. I received a BA in music education from Bethune Cookman College, Daytona Beach, in 3.5 years. MA, School Administration and Supervision, FAMU, 1978. School Principal Certification, 1990. Served in the 80th Army Band in Honolulu, Savannah, Georgia, from 1971 to 1974. Served in the Army Reserve from 1974 to 1988. I started teaching in Taylor County in 1974 as a classroom music teacher. 1976, I was assigned as a band director at the high school and junior high school. In 1985, I was assigned as assistant principal at Taylor County Junior High School. In 1989, and school principal at Dennis Morse Elementary School. The name changed to Taylor County West Elementary School. Well, somewhere around 1997, the school was closed in 2002. I was assigned to Taylor Technical Institute in 2002 as an industry services coordinator. I retired after 36 years of service to the Taylor County School District. In June 2010, I tell folks they tricked me out the door because they told me I had to leave. I was called to pastor Springfield Missionary Baptist Church at the age of 36. I served 28 years as the longest serving pastor in the church's 161-year history. Called to pastor New Mount Zion Missionary Baptist Church in 1992, 23 years, second longest in church 99-year history. We will celebrate 100 years of continued service in February 2016. I hope I said something of interest. Thank you so much.
Many things that you said made me think that
good to hear somebody that gives a kind of testimony that you have. And also, I want to say Shiloh will celebrate its 163rd anniversary of September. And that's the oldest continuing church in the county. They say, but if yours was in June, then you got to be.
That's a mess.
If anybody had a question, would you feel?
Oh, sure.
If you feel like that, if I had any question, Mary Jo asked me a couple of times, I was listening to you, didn't want to answer, so I was trying to answer.
Sure.
I was just wondering about the 96-year-old. You said she went to the University of Florida, and did they let her take classes at that time?
She took what was called a certification class over the summer. When the teachers were at Jerkins, they had to be certified. They had to be certified by the state board. They didn't have to have a high school diploma, they had to be certified. So she worked and helped to certify to teach in Dixon County. She took an exam, or Frank took an exam. She was certified to teach there at grade for 1 year. Next year, she had no way to certify, and all the places where she could get her certification was at the University of Florida. So she was allowed to, my understanding, to go on campus and take that particular class.
Because her grandma was pregnant.
I actually called. She probably called her. She gets around, she still drives. Go to Berlin there every day.
Wow.
I knew the board of behaviors from what I had understood.
Can I ask a personal question?
Yes, ma'am.
How old are you?
I used to ask the kids how old I did.
Did you say you graduated from high school?
The two of you got out of gray hair. 1967 and 68.
I graduated in 66.
That
means it was one year and a half.
You were one year and a half. I'm 65, I think. 69.
65.
Well, mine's 67.
I'm 67.
You're 67?
You got to be more than that.
When Horace McCloud was living,